Thank you, Abba Father, we praise your name. We lift your name on high, King Jesus. You're worthy, you're worthy of our worship. You're worthy of our praises. You're worthy of our adoration.
Jesus.
We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We worship you. Lord, we sanctify your holy name. There is none like you, Abba Father. We lift your name on high, King Jesus. We worship you, Father. We praise you, Lord.
There is none.
Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Thank you, Father. We lift your name on high, my King Jesus. We lift your name on high, my King Jesus. We give you all the glory, Jehovah, Lord.
Together, even as we share from the book of Genesis chapter number 22. Genesis chapter number 22 and from verse 12 to 13. Let's read. Genesis chapter 22 verse 12 to 13. Do not lay a hand on the boy. He said, do not do anything to him. Now I know that you are fear. Now I know that you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son. Abram looked up there in a thicket. He saw a ram caught by its horn. He went over and took the ram and sacrificed it as burnt offering instead of his son. So Abram called that place, "The Lord will provide," and to his day it said, "On the mountain of the Lord will provide." Amen. Right from where we have read today, we can see this is what was happening. Abraham was a man who loved God, and God wanted to test his faith. He told him, after giving him a son in the old age, that he should sacrifice this son. He should give his son as a living sacrifice to him. Then Abraham, he did not hesitate. Instead, he took the son and he went up the place of sacrifice. But when he reached there, because he was in the hands of the Lord, he accepted to remain in the hands of the Lord. And there he listened to God. This being in the hands of the Lord, I think it is listening from God's direction and being ready to be directed of God. And therefore, Abraham took his son there. While he was just almost about to sacrifice Isaac, and the angel of the Lord was sent to him. And because he was in the hands of the Lord and everything was in his hand of God, now God spoke to him, "Look, there is a provision for a lamb. Do not finish your son. Do not sacrifice your son. There is a ram there to sacrifice. Now I know your heart is together with me. You love me." Abraham was being tested of his faith. And now, after a testing of his faith, We can see that now Abraham passed this test because he was together in step with God, in the hands of God. And now today's message, right from there, I won't go to so many things. I'm talking about in the hands of the Lord. Come on, tell your neighbor, in the hands of the Lord. If you are there together with somebody, greet him and say, it is good, it is safe to be in the hands of the Lord. And here we can see some few backgrounds about this book of Genesis. Genesis, it is talking about the beginnings of the beginnings, or the genesis of everything, and the genesis of bad things, the genesis of good things, and the beginning of our blessings and the beginning of curses. Oh, when you are in the hands of the Lord, this is what I'm seeing. You will walk with the blessings of the Lord. You will overcome every power, every circumstances of the enemy. And here now I have seen you will be in steps. When you are in the hands of the Lord, you will be in understanding according to the will of the Lord, and you will do what God requires you to do. And here, that's why I have seen that it is good to be in the hands of the Lord. Come on, remind your neighbor, in the hands of the Lord. The history of Isaac and Abraham, it is reminding me to be in the hands of the Lord so that I may do the will of God. And brethren, I love this, that in the hands of the Lord, there is so many things. You know, when you say you are in the hands of somebody, this means that who cares about you, if it is bad things or good things, or whatever it outcome comes out of whatever you are, it means that it is about that particular person. And now, if today we can say, I am in the hands of our king, any other king of this land, then it means that I am safe. If there is bad things to happen to me, then it means that he is honorable. Or if good things happens to me, he is the genesis, or he is the cause of that particular thing. And now here, I speak that it is good rather to be, not to be in other hands, but be in the hands of God. And when you are in the hands of the Lord of Lords, oh, this is what can come out. Security is our portion. Come on, tell your neighbor, even if in this particular moment of pathetic situation in the country or in the world, I want to remind you, you as a believer, you don't need to be in the hands of the enemy, but you need to be in the hands of the Lord. Come on, tell your neighbor, it is good to be in the hands of the Lord, because security will be your portion. In the hands of the Lord, another thing I can see, Abraham here, Abraham's heart was healed. In the hands of the Lord, there is healing. Abraham, I know he was going to sacrifice this son, but now I was seeing, the only son I have, God has given me the old age, but now again I'm giving him out. Oh, I know he was giving out, but maybe the heart was somehow with a sickness. He was ill in another way, but now I can realize, after God sending the angel and saying, do not touch your son, and he provided for a lamb. This is a portion of healing. Oh, in the hands of the Lord, instead of death, there is healing. Tell your neighbor, death is not your portion, but healing is your portion. Good health is your portion. Hallelujah. And in the hands of the Lord, security is our portion. As we say, security is our portion. Isaac was to be sacrificed, but instead, the ram was sacrificed. Oh, while in the hands of the Lord. And Abraham said, when he was asked by Isaac, I'm seeing you are carrying a panga and firewood, but I'm not seeing the ram. And Abraham said, the Lord will provide. And surely, security was provided to Isaac at that particular moment, because he trusted the Lord. The Lord is our provider. The Lord was to provide. Come on, say amen. Hallelujah. The Lord provided for the security. And now I can see our God, while we are in his hand, in the horns of the Lord will provide. The Lord provided for a ram. And I know when the ram was sacrificed from Noah, oh, when we are walking in the hands of the Lord, what we don't know, what we don't have, what we are aiming to receive, maybe even what we had not planned to receive, God will always be our provider. In your financial status, God is providing. In your educational status, God is providing. In your projects, God is providing. In the name of Jesus, just as he provided the lamb, I'm saying again, he will have to provide in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We trust in the Lord who is Jehovah Jireh. His name is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord, the provider. In his hand, there is provision. Come on, say, in his hand, there is provision. Maybe your financial status is going down. Your business is going down. Whatever is going down. But I want to assure you, remain, do not come out of the hands of the Lord. When you remain in his hand, your business will rise again. When you remain in his hand, your provision will rise again. In Jesus' mighty name. I can see another lesson here. I can see in the hands of the Lord, there is restoration. There is restoration. Come on. Oh, instead of harming Isaac, his son, when the ram was brought, the restoration of the son, his only son, was there. He was realized, and Isaac was not harmed. Isaac was restored again. And now I say, there is restoration in the name of Jesus. In another lesson I can see, in the hands of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, before I go to the last one, I'm seeing there is restoration in the hands of the Lord. Restoration of our job, restoration of your business, restoration of your health. There is restoration in Jesus' name. In the hands of the Lord, there is increase. Come on, tell your neighbor, there is increase in the hands of the Lord. The Father, the Bible says, after this test, the Bible says that God made Abraham to be, because he was in the hands of the Lord, you shall be the father of many nations. Many nations. Come on, say, you are the father of many nations. This to say, you will increase. God will expand your territories. God will expand your financial status. God will expand even your education. God will expand your projects. God will deal with your enemies so that he may enlarge your territory. In his hands, it is a safe place to be. And I can see in his hand, when God increases, he will increase our life. Come on, tell your neighbor, God is increasing your life. God is increasing you educationally. God is increasing you in your projects. God is increasing you in your business. God is increasing your financial status. Hallelujah. I don't know what has made you maybe to begin doubting your faith with the Lord, to begin doubting your steps in the Lord. You can change today with me and say, today I have heard in the hands of the Lord. It is the safest place to be, and I want to return back in the hands of the Lord, because there is no any other Lord than him. There is no any other God than him. He is the Alpha and the Omega. And now I urge you, we pray together, even as we wind up this word today. If you have a financial need, if you have got a job need, maybe if you have got a business need, we can still pray together and speak to our God. Our family need, your family need, we can still trust the Lord and pray together in Jesus' mighty name. Our heaven God, thank you for giving us such a wonderful sermon today, that in your hands there is provision, in your hands there is security, in your hands, oh God, there is provision, in your hands there is a good life, in your hands everything is sure, and in your hands
the enemy will not get us. Even coronavirus will not get us. Even other situations will not overcome us because of your power of the Holy Spirit. And now I pray for our listeners today. I pray for our lives that you take charge in Jesus' mighty name as you break the power of satanic force in Jesus' mighty name. I send healing upon that sick man, sick woman, and sick young person in the name of the Lord. I pray for that child to receive healing in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for those who have been backsliding to be restored back to you in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for those who have been going through financial strain to receive their strength again in Jesus' mighty name. Your miracles, Father, to accompany them in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for your power of the Holy Spirit to touch them in Jesus' name. We do believe and pray. Amen and amen.